Hello and welcome to the show that people are calling Aim Down Sights. Aim Down Sights. This week I'm joined by a very special guest, this limited edition Advanced Warfare Xbox One console. Thanks for joining us. We're also joined by the console's bodyguard, Graham Boyd from Xbox. So thanks too, I guess. Nah, not really. It's good to see you, mate. It's been a while.
Indeed, it has. Thanks for having me here. This is Ace.
No, absolute pleasure. So, obviously, I know all about you, but I guess some of the audience might not. So, can you tell us a little about yourself?
Yeah, I can. So, my name's Graham Boyd. I'm AC Bongos on Xbox Live and on Twitter as well. And I work in the European Xbox marketing team. And I do a ton of work with the Call of Duty community, both in Europe and kind of globally as well. You know, events and hosting some live streams, things like that. So, real pleasure to be here. Thanks for asking.
Great to have you on. Right, let's find out a little more about this, bad boy. No, not you, Graham.
No.
Right, Graham, so yes, you've brought this in with you.
Yep.
I'm guessing there's not many of these around at the moment.
No, and I had to guard this with my life over the weekend, and actually on the train here today I was panicking. But yeah, it's here safely.
So. It's arrived nice today. A few scuffs on it I noticed though.
That wasn't me.
No?
I just want to make that clear. I didn't damage it at all. No, I think, you know, what you're saying is the point of this console is to really reflect the Sentinel Task Force in the game, you know. Whenever we do a special edition console, it's very much about like fan service, you know, and Sledgehammer Games and Xbox both work really closely on the design for this one. So the design of the console and the controller as well, reflect the Sentinel Task Force. Now they're a little bit rough and ready, right? The kit that they use isn't necessarily, you know, totally clean and cutting edge. The Atlas Corporation is very sleek.
Yeah.
But the Sentinel Task Force, you know, they're kind of a little bit rough around the edges. So you can see that here. There's some scuffs and some oil marks as well. But the colouring is designed to reflect those guys in the game. And it also reflects the limited edition exoskeleton.
The bullet brass exoskeleton.
Exactly.
Right.
So that's the bullet brass colouring on here. So yeah. And there's loads of nice little touches. You know, you've got the Sentinel Task Force logo on here, which is like the Spartan helmet with the wings that signify speed and stealth. And just lots of nice little details. There's a cool QR code up here as well, which if you scan that, gets you something really cool. But actually, what's inside the console is really exciting as well. There's a 1 terabyte hard drive in here. You can't see it, but trust me, it's
so
in
is this the first Xbox One to have a terabyte hard drive?
Absolutely.
Right.
Yeah. And again, that's us listening to fans. You know, Xbox One owners have been telling us that they want more storage, so this is a first step towards that. You can also still extend the storage using external hard drives as well. So yeah, 1 terabyte is tons of space for all your games and downloads.
Good stuff. I do like the scuff aesthetic because it's my favorite kind of sci-fi stuff. I like the stuff that's been worn and used and looks like it's kind of lived in.
Well, that's it. It's meant to look like, and you can see it on the controller as well, it's meant to look like this has been on the field of battle, you know. It's not totally box fresh.
So yeah, tell us a little about the features on here, because we were kind of talking of this earlier. There's loads of kind of little, it's weird to say Easter eggs.
Yeah,
but this is a pad loaded with kind of odd little details. What can you tell us about?
That's what I love about the partnership between Xbox and Sledgehammer Games. You know, you could just make a stand, you know, color the console or do something fairly vanilla. But there's lots of little touches in here that just kind of, you know, really connect to the fan base a little bit more. So you can see there is some fire select stuff on here. There's some range finding stuff. There's some nice little kill counts, little marks on the controller.
Yep.
There's a little smiley face on the side here.
I was saying earlier, I thought you just drawn that on with Biro earlier as a little signature.
No, I was going to sign the back, but no, I thought I'd just leave it. You know, so just all these little things that really kind of bring the fiction of the game to life, you know, in the console and the controller as well.
Excellent. So I understand you also get a digital copy of the game.
That's right, and it's a day zero edition as well.
So you get 24-hour access.
That's right,
access
you can play
November
the 3rd. You get double XP on that day as well, so that's
nice.
Great. There is that exclusive exoskeleton included in the console as well, which is bullet brass, so that exoskeleton will mirror the look and feel of the console here.
That's the colour of the D-pad.
That's right.
I was wondering what bullet brass
bullet
is.
Bullet brass. It's based on, you know, old artillery casings or the bullet casings that you see, that kind of, that really nice deep brass colour. So they put a ton of work into getting that finish right. A couple of exclusive weapons included in that as well. The AK-12G assault rifle and the crossbow B2 as well. So tons of stuff included. And, probably my favourite feature, And I know like people go nuts for this as well. It's got custom sounds on the console as well.
Nice.
So when you turn the console on, you get the mute charge sound. When you eject the disc, you get an exo boost sound. And when you turn it off, you get that powerful sound of the warbird flying in action as well. So just some really, really nice touches there.
I do like the custom sounds. I used to like that on the old 360 consoles when they did that.
So much of a difference. And again, it's just, you know, more nice little details that just make the whole package really cool.
It's pretty complete, isn't it? So are these available for pre-order now?
Available for pre-order now. They are going fast. I'm not just saying that. They genuinely are. It's $429 in the UK and $499 as well.
Lovely. All right. Thank you very much for the overview, Graham. I think it's time for some spectator mode. Not only were Gamescom attendees lucky enough to get hands-on time with Advanced Warfare, they were also given a front-row seat to watch pro gamers battling it out in exhibition matches. Such an occasion required a very special commentary team, and so Activision enlisted the services of Team Envious co-founder Hastro and professional esports caster Benson, a cross-Atlantic dream team if ever I saw one. I caught up with them after a hard day's commentating to get their views on Advanced Warfare's esports prospects.
It's very interesting to watch a professional gamer play a new iteration of Call of Duty for the first time because they're so used to the last iteration and they're so good at it, but then they have to essentially kind of relearn things. And here with Advanced Warfare, it's even much more so because there are so many new things in this game that have changed mechanically from past Call of Duty titles. So the professional players here have been a joy to watch because we can actually call them out on things that they are screwing up on, you know? They're completely screwing up.
All the way over to the other side of the map, his teammate doing some good slaying, but he's opted to throw it, and he's completely misthrown the ball.
But we also saw flashes of brilliance out of some of these guys, just pure skill.
Everyone's starting on a clean slate right now. Everyone's at the same level. So we've seen some pretty epic fails, I'm not gonna lie, some jump fails falling off the map a fair few times, but we've also seen some epically amazing plays. Like the stuff you see in the trailers that you sit at home and you think, no, that never happens. Well, we've seen it happen live here on the very first day of Gamescom. The pick 13 system and the way that that's been used is so good. Having score streaks in the pick system changes the game completely because then you have players have to make a conscious decision. Do I want to run score streaks or do I want to try and become a super soldier? Do I want to stack on perks? Do I want to have extra attachments? And one of the biggest things we've seen a lot of is obviously Exo Stim, the ability Stim, which gives you a quicker health regen after gunfights. And we also seen the speed boost as well.
I'm changing mags.
From the pro players that we're hearing that they like the extra ability and the ways that they can get around the map faster and the verticality of the maps now. They're also already trying to give input, you know? They want to give feedback, which is always positive. That's nothing new. We've seen that with every Call of Duty title. And these guys are just eager to help make the game even better than it already is in the build that we have here at Gamescom. The community is a very vocal community, the Call of Duty community. So one thing I will say about that, mentioning that they're so vocal, is that reading my Twitter timeline coming off of casting, I've never seen so much positivity about a new Call of Duty game since, you know, Call of Duty 4 back in 2007. So I told that to Michael and he was, you know, very happy about that. So I there's a lot of positivity.
So while they were commentating on the events of the multiplayer matches at Gamescom, you had quite a pivotal role to play prior to all that, didn't you?
Pivotal might be exaggerating a little bit, but thank you for that. Yeah, no, me and Major Nelson hosted the world premiere multiplayer reveal for Advanced Warfare, which was great, actually. And part of the reason I really liked it was that Activision bust in from all over Europe, real, genuine Call of Duty fans.
Road to Gamescom bus,
indeed,
yes.
Indeed, and had them in the room there as well. So there was a really, really nice atmosphere. And I think, you know, that said a lot because, you know, there's a lot of focus on Call of Duty this year. So to bring the fans in there and have them at the center of those announcements and showing all the great new stuff off for the first time was really powerful. You know, it was a lot of fun. You know, it was sort of a 45-minute presentation, but the amount of stuff that was packed in there, it was just announcements after announcement after announcement. And then everyone getting to get hands-on immediately after was really cool. But yeah, the feedback was great. I think people are really pleased that there is this extra dimension being added to the game now. So yeah.
Good stuff. Right, talking of extra dimensions, let's find out about the latest Exo abilities in a new Heads Up. One of the biggest tactical decisions you'll have to make in Advanced Warfare's multiplayer is deciding which of the various exo abilities and perks you're going to deck out your operator with. Here's a short video that showcases the strategic advantages these brand new boosts will give you in combat.
Along with the all-new exo movement, the exoskeleton can also be equipped with player-selected exo abilities, which require strategic use of the exo's battery, like hover, cloak, and shield. The Exo Trophy System ability can destroy up to 2 incoming enemy projectiles. If enemies begin throwing grenades in your direction, it will engage, physically knocking the grenades back and away from you. And for lethal and tactical deployment, your wrist-mounted launcher offers a variety of projectiles, from frag and smoke grenades to fan favorites like the Semtex and EMP grenade, to new equipment like the Threat Grenade or Tracking Drone. Advanced Warfare features new perks based around your Exo, and when your Exo suit's battery needs more energy, the Overcharge perk gives you the upper hand, allowing you to cloak or hover for longer periods of time. Exo movement increases the overall strategy in combat, and Exo abilities are balanced to be just as powerful as the next, giving players the choice of the combination that works for them. Equipping your Exo to enhance your playing style and strategically implementing your attacks will be the key to victory in Advanced Warfare multiplayer.
Now we've seen the Exo abilities in action, it's time to find out which of them are going to make it into your loadout. First, we've got Ross Hoare, who says, I will probably use the Exo Hover just so I can pretend I'm a bird coming to rain pain down below. Not sure if that's what birds generally do.
It's a pretty aggressive bird.
He's a very aggressive bird. Maybe a kestrel.
There you go. Well, I think it's such an important point that, you know, we keep talking to it. The verticality that the Exo is going to be able to open up, the way that opens up the map for you, and the way it gives you extra kind of aggressive options. You know, imagine sniping using Exo Hover. Could be a very, very cool advantage for your team.
Oh God, I'd hope there's no quick scoping in this one combined with that. It's going to be a nightmare. You Never Lol says, I think Exo Overclock is going in my loadout because I can quickly get away from a dangerous scenario. So Overclock, being able to just kind of dash out, boosting your Exo's abilities very briefly to kind of get out somewhere quickly, could be good. As with all Call of Duties, you can only take a very limited number of shots, so as soon as the red mist starts to show up, I guess it's a chance just to get out of there, and hopefully they don't have Overclock as well to follow you.
Yeah, but also to get in. You know, when you think about the objective-based game modes, that's going to be a great advantage for you, you know, to grab flags and things like that.
Uplink, for example, I think it'd be a great one to do a kind of a dash.
Yeah, that sprint.
Finally, New Year's Project says, I will definitely be using Exo Ping. You can never underestimate, you like the word ping.
I love it, yeah, it's
you
the
can
best
never
name game, yeah.
underestimate the value of knowing where the enemy is at all times. Again, offers a completely different set of tactics. Mm-hmm. Somebody with ping, especially in a team, could be the recon guy, basically. And if they are communicating as the best multiplayer teams do, they can actually kind of spot enemies for other players to take out.
Yeah, that's a huge advantage. It's almost like having Oracle mode, you know, in multiplayer. And I think we're seeing it show up in campaign as well with those ping grenades that are showing up where enemies are. So, you know, again, probably more for deathmatch setups, that's going to be a really great advantage to be able to know where everyone is before you turn that corner.
Absolutely. Right, so which of those was your favorite?
So I think we've got to go with Ross Hoare talking about, you know, Exo Hover, just because for me, the biggest change in the game, particularly in multiplayer, is going to be, you know, that the added verticality of the Exo abilities will be able to give you, getting up high, being able to help your team out, and just the wealth of new options that opens up. So yeah, I'm going for Ross.
There you go. Well done, Ross. You've just won yourself a 12-month Xbox Live Gold subscription. Now, for next week's Go Loud, I'd like to know, basically, the score streaks are making a return in Advanced Warfare. So I'd like to know which of Black Ops 2 score streaks, because that was the previous game to have score streaks, that you'd like to see make a comeback, and how you'd update it for the new futuristic setting. Tweet your thoughts at GameSpot using the hashtag AimDown for the chance to win a shiny 12-month Xbox Live Gold subscription. Right, time is up on this episode of AimDown Sights. Graham, thank you very, very much for joining me.
My pleasure.
What's next for you as far as Advanced Warfare goes?
Lots to come, can't talk about it all, but I'm really excited about Day Zero. I think that's such a cool initiative, you know, for fans to get to be able to play the game a day early, of course get double XP on that day as well, which will help me out a lot particularly. But priority first of all is get this wee monkey back to the office without getting mugged.
Yeah, good luck with that.
No, thanks. I'll need it.
I might be the one doing the mugging. Don't forget that you can follow Graham on Twitter at acbongos2, should you so wish. Thank you very much for watching. We'll see you next time. So, what are you doing after the show? Anything good? Anything nice?
Call of Duty Advanced Warfare. Pre-order now for Xbox.